Massive buildings, shuttle launches, fast cars. Yeah, they are all incredible. But I honestly still think the greatest engineered creation in human history is Linux. It completely changed the world of software engineering. You might say that AI is a peak of engineering, but there wouldn't be no AI without Linux running behind the scenes. A friend of mine has many years of experience, senior software engineer, tech lead in big companies, and he still says that he should learn Linux. In this video, I talk about why it's so awesome. When we talk about Linux, the first thing we should understand is what open source software means. Basically, there's a place on the internet where people share their code publicly. Other people can use it, change it for their own need, or even suggest improvements after the original project. And here's the crazy part. Most of these contributions are made just for love of it, not for money. You really don't see this kind of collaboration in other fields of engineering. So when you use an open source project, you're using something that has been built and improved over the years by thousands of experts around the world, thousands of unique perspectives. Linux is one of those softwares. So why is Linux important? Before answering to this question, hey guys, my name is Parsa. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. If you've been here before, welcome back. These videos of mine may seem easy to create, but they're not. They take me a lot of energy and time, and I really appreciate it if you support my channel. Here's why Linux is such a big deal. Most of the internet literally runs on it. Almost every major server, supercomputer, and cloud platforms are powered by Linux. Your favorite websites, streaming services, and even banking systems are probably running on the Linux machine. Some banking systems are not, and that's why they get hacked. Companies don't just use Linux, they rely on it. Because it's fast, stable, super secure, customizable, and resource aware. Hold on, a lot of words. Let's break them down together. By stable, I mean it doesn't stop unless you tell it to. And that really matters, because servers are big computers which have to work all the time. And even when it comes to updates, it's nothing like Windows, which just decides to shut everything down whenever it wants. It is super secure because of its permission system. It is customizable because we have different distros for it. And it's resource aware because Linux has tons of features and mechanisms that split the computing resources between different processes. That matters a lot, and we actually need this idea for the next part of this video. So when you learn Linux, you're not just learning another operating system. You're learning the backbone of modern computing. What does even that mean? I mean, okay, backbone of modern computing. So what? As a software engineer or DevOps engineer or SRE or any other related role, you should be able to get into any server, do what you're supposed to do, and get out of it. That's why it matters. There is a history about it. When it was created, by whom? Linux was created by one person, but built by thousands. That's the power of open source. That's why here you see Linux kernel and not whole Linux. To be honest, over the past years, I had nothing to do with its history, so I don't mention it, at least in this video. The only important part to me was that open source thing. But it's not Linux itself that we interact with every day. There are some tools which shape the modern software engineering, and most of them are built almost entirely on top of Linux. Those resource-aware features inspired so many tools that we use today. Take Docker, for example, which we talked about in previous videos. It has this concept called the container. Docker didn't invent containers, Linux did. Docker just made them easy, and Kubernetes made them scalable. And Docker and Kubernetes are just the famous examples. There are tons of other tools that exist because of Linux. Why was this important to me as a junior software engineer? Because I realized something. I don't always have to invent the original idea, even if I'm Docker. I can always take good ideas, build on top of them, and still be creative. Same with music too, but that's kind of a long story. In the next videos of this playlist, I talk about Linux basic commands for any Linux user, its permission system, some of its resource-aware features, and some parts of its structure. By the way, let me share a bit about my audience stats. I kind of have to assign my audience to my Git and my Docker videos weren't performing that well. My first popular video was a vlog and the next two was about Golang. I think that's a hint. But I think that doesn't matter that much because I have to share anything I know anyways. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the like button if this video might help you. Don't forget to subscribe. Be curious and keep learning.